In this video, I want to show you how to create interactive map with DeepSeek AI. DeepSeek AI is an interesting AI that I've shown you previously how to create accounts with them. But in this exercise, I want to show you how to create an interactive map with this AI called DeepSeek. Now, to do that, you need to give instruction to AI. So let's just say I want to plot a busiest airport in the world on an interactive map. Now I need to give further instructions for clarity's sake. So let me say clicking on a point, it should show the name of the airport, its rank, and number of passengers. So what I'm trying to do is to give the AI the instruction of exactly what I want. So I want the passengers, the rank, and the name of the airport. So furthermore, I can give further details on what I want. Let's say I will be using Python in Google Colab for this. So this is a detailed instruction I've given to DeepSeek. So DeepSeek also have web search. So the essence of this web search, it will be able to look for updated information, up-to-date information. And also DeepSeek is a reasoning that will help to sort out the information collected. So after I've done this, I'll just click on send. So guys, you can see the thinking is ongoing and the AI is collecting the informations and it's step by step showing me how to do it and also creating code for each of the steps. So guys, you can see what the AI is doing, DeepSeek, what it's doing. So it's creating the steps and the code. So after that, you can see, let me scroll up. So you can see it has given us step by step. Like step one is for us to install the required libraries. So we need to install libraries that's giving us the code as well. And step two is to prepare the data. So you need a data set containing the busiest airport with their names, rank, number of passengers, and the coordinates. So you can see it has given me the data, the name of the airport, this is it in the code, and the ranking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It has been ranked. And you can see the number of passengers in millions. And one beautiful thing about this is that it also gave me the coordinates, latitude and longitude. So you can see the data frame. Then it also gave me step three, which is to create the interactive map. So you can see the code as well. So now let's use Google Colab. So open a new tab and type Google Colab. So when it's open, this first link, Google Colab. So scroll down. Once you have Google account, you can use it. So just click on the new notebook. So it will open a new page and open the coding section. So when it opens, it automatically titles your project. So here, let's give it a unique title to make it easier for us to identify in case you have other projects. So let's call it airports, for instance. Then here is where we enter the code after naming our project. But to do that, we need to go back to DeepSeek, then scroll up and go to step one. The step one is that we install required libraries. This is what DeepSeek think we should do. So just copy the code of that step one, go back to Colab and paste the code here, then click on run. when you click on run, it's connecting to Python 3 Google Compute Engine. Then it will install the Folium Pandas. So you can see in few seconds it has been installed. So this is it. Then the next thing, come here and add code pan sheet or code cell. So click on it. It has been added. Then go back to DeepSeek and go to step 2, which is prepare the data. And the data has been prepared for us. You can see the airport name, every information, and even the coordinates. And the passenger is in millions. So you can see the coordinates here. You can see everything. Then just copy this code and go back to Colab. Then here, come and paste the code. After pasting the code here, click on run. So in matter of few seconds, in fact, it's completed. So that one is done without any problem. So the next thing is to add another code cell. So just click here. Another code cell has been added. Then go back to DeepSeek. Move to step 3, which is to create the interactive map. So to do that, we have the code here. So Folium, create an interactive map and add markers for each point. So just copy the code for the step 3. Then go back to Colab and paste the code here in this cell. And once you pasted it, click on run. Then in few seconds, yes, it will generate the map. Wow, this is beautiful. It has generated the map of busiest airport in the world. The 5 busiest airports in the world. So you can see it here. You can see it. This is the 5 busiest airports in the world. Then remember, if we go to our instructions, we said that clicking on a point is to show the name of the airport, its rank, and numbers of passengers. So let's see if it was able to achieve this. So let's go back to our map generated. Click on any of the points. Yes, you can see this. This is the name of the airport, Dubai International Airport. You can see the rank, you can see the number of passengers. And if you click on this, another one, you can see Belgium Capital International Airport. You can see the rank, number 2. And you can see the number of passengers, 100 million. And if you click on this one also, you can see the name of the airport. You can see the rank and you can see the passenger. Now, in a case where you want to make it more interactive, so let's go back and tell the software, let's give another command. I want to color the markers based on rank. Rank 1 in red, 2 in blue, 3 in yellow, 4 in green, and 5 in purple. So display, let's say, the legend that shows this categorization on the lower right corner of the screen. So we want to do it in such a way that it can be easily identified. So just click on send. Then it will create the code again. You can see it. So it's creating the code to give specific color to each of the marker. So you can see it. Yes, it's done. So just come back here. You can see the ranking in color from 1 to 5 different color. Here, just copy this code, then go back to our map, then scroll down and add another code cell. So just click add code cell, then here paste the code we copied. Yes, you can see it here, it has been pasted. Then if you look here, you can see the information. You can see the ranking in with color is well defined. Then take note here, if in your case this data is not showing as it's showing in my own case, then you need to go and copy the initial code for the data set. But in my own case, it's showing. So then I'll just click on run. Yes, it's completed. So let me just scroll down. You can see the map, specific color for each of the marker. You can see it here. You can see it. You can see it. And here is the legend, ranking colors. So each rank with specific color, you can see it. So you can see how beautiful and easy it is to create an interactive map with DeepSeek. This is it. So in the next video, we'll be showing you how to do more or better map with DeepSeek. So at your own time, you can do more.